Hello. I am Abdijalil Adejima, your instructor for today. We are going to be treating angles. Angles. What is an angle? An angle can be defined as the figure formed by two lines meeting at a common endpoint. An angle is represented by the symbol over here. This symbol is the symbol of an angle. Here, the angle below, which is by this side, is angle AOB. This is the angle in the red color. Part of an angle. Arms. The two lines joining to form an angle are called arms of an angle. Here, OA. Look at this one. OA and OB are the arms of angle AOB. And the vertex. The vertex, the common endpoint at which the two lines meet. This is the common endpoint. We can be seen with the dot. This is where the dot is here, which is zero, which is O. That's where the place of the dot is called what? It's called the vertex. Here, the point O is the vertex of angle what? Angle AOB. A revolution. A revolution is one complete turn, as we can measure the length, so we can also measure angle. One revolution is divided into 360 parts. Each part is called a degree. We use the symbol 0 here at the top here for degree. This symbol is also used to represent degree. One revolution is 360 degree, while 1 degree equals 1 over 360 revolution. And angle can also be measured clockwise or anti-clockwise. That one we explain this later. And this is a diagram of a full revolution, a full angle, which is called a 360 degree angle. Types of angle. Angle have special names depending on their size. The first one we'll be looking into is an acute angle. Acute angle is an angle between 0 and 90 degrees. That means an angle that is from 0 to 89.99999 degrees. Or let me say to 89 degrees. That means the angle is not up to 90 degrees. That means any angle between 0 and 90 degrees is called an acute angle. Next, a right angle. A right angle is an angle at 90 degrees. That means a right angle is an angle at 90 degrees. Any angle at 90 degrees is called a right angle. An obtuse angle. An obtuse angle is an angle greater than 90 degrees. An obtuse angle is what? Is greater than 90 degrees, but not 90 degrees. That means greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. That's the summary of the definition. The angle is greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. And those are the example of an obtuse angle. You can see 160 degrees is greater than 90 and less than 180 degrees. Same thing goes with 168 degrees. You can see it is still less than what? 180 degrees, but greater than 90 degrees. Same goes with 94 degrees. It is less than what? It is greater than 90 degrees, but less than 180 degrees. The next angle is a straight angle. A straight angle. A straight angle is an angle at 180 degrees. A straight line angle. We call it straight angle. That means an angle on a straight line is what? 180 degrees. A reflex angle. A reflex angle is an angle greater than 180 degrees and less than what? 360 degrees. That means an example is 180 degrees, 300 degrees, 359 degrees. Because 359 degrees is less than 360 degrees. 181 degrees also is an reflex angle. And this is a diagram showing the example of a reflex angle. Now, we are now going to a compass. A protractor, rather, I'm sorry. To measure the degree in an angle, an instrument called a protractor will be used. Well, a protractor is an instrument used to measure angle. For example, This is the label of the protractor, an example of a protractor. This is the center of the protractor over here, and this is where it begins, where the red dot is. If you start from here, from zero here, the inner part is anti-clockwise way. That means you are counting to your left, and you know a clock move to the right, and this one is a clockwise way. The outer scale 0, 10, 20, that's what they call it, outer scale, and it is in clockwise direction. Example here, this is our compass. Now they give us an angle here. This is an angle we are measuring. You can see the vertex is at the center. Anytime you want to measure an angle, make sure the vertex where the two arm join is placed. This protractor center is placed at that point. Now, looking at this angle, counting from here, you can see from 22, this is 20 over here. You know, look at this 160. We are using the inner scale. We are counting anti-clockwise. That means you look at the 20 here, this is 20, 21, and 22. Now 22 minus 59, it will give us 37. That means the angle over here is 37 degrees. Next, now measure the size of the angle ABC using a protractor. Using what? Protractor. Now this is the angle. You have angle ABC. Now, how do you measure using protractor? I've told you like that. Make sure the center of the protractor and this vertex here are equal when measuring the angle, and you make sure it is on a straight line. Next, here is the solution. You can see this is the angle over here, and this is the vertex. The vertex is on the same point with the center of the protractor. Now, counting anti-clockwise, we started from zero, which after counting 10, 20, 30, 40, and oops, this is it. Now 71, 72. Next, I hope you understand this explanation. That means our angle label here, display mark red here, is what? Angle B is what? Is 72 degrees. Now, in summary, in this class, we look at angle and types of angle. And we say acute angle is an angle between 0 and 90 degrees. A right angle is an angle at 90 degrees, while an obtuse angle is an angle greater than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees. And also we said a straight angle is an angle at 180 degrees, while a reflex angle is an angle greater than 180 degrees but less than 360 degrees, while a complete angle which is a revolution is what is angle at 360 degrees. Now you make sure you do this exercise, you attempt this exercise, and submit it to the right.